Like any piece of tech, military gear has a limited time before it becomes outdated, leaving its users searching for a successor. With the Sikorsky CH-53K King Stallion heavy lift cargo helicopter, it looks like the United States Marine Corps just got a very expensive AI-infused upgrade. Superseding the 1981 Sikorsky CH-53E Super Stallion, the all-new King Stallion packs all kinds of new tricks and substantial upgrades, as its lofty price tag indicates. Slated for release in 2023 or 2024, pending trial runs with the hardware, the King Stallion broke into Forbes headlines with its revolutionary pilot assistance features built directly into the helicopter's fly-by-wire flight controls, serving similar purposes as parking assistance and obstacle avoidance features baked into most modern cars. The King Stallion is both the largest and most powerful helicopter the U.S. Armed Services has ever incorporated into service. Lockheed Martin, the parent company of the King Stallion's manufacturer, Sikorsky, has packed three full-size 7,500 SHP General Electric GE38-1B turboshaft engines into the craft, throwing all that state-of-the-art power behind the main seven-blade rotor. The sheer force generated by these engines is capable of lifting 27,000 pounds in flight over extremely long distances, specifically 110 nautical miles. Yes, nautical. The King Stallion was developed with the Pacific and the United States Armed Forces' lengthy involvement there in mind, just as its predecessor, Super Stallion, was. This carrying capacity is mainly used for airlifting up to 55 troops at a time, in addition to a substantial amount of equipment, but also extends to armored vehicles and even other aircraft, though these would have to be externally tethered. With all this to factor in, along with the regular complicated task of flying a helicopter in the first place, and the additional pressures flying a mission through a war zone could induce, it's no wonder the Marines and Lockheed opted for a level of limited autonomization. Apparently, the new flight assistance features are meant to take care of some relatively menial tasks and increase coordination between co-pilots, as well as decrease the amount of attention necessary for flight, thus freeing up pilots' focus for more difficult and involved tasks. Making takeoff and landing on water vessels easier and safer is one of the prime directives of the King Stallion's Flight Control Assistance AI, which it does by factoring in a variety of internal and external and environmental factors, including wind speed, altitude, information coming from both the main rotor and the tail rotor, and certain readings from the three engines. The King Stallion's AI features three progressively interventive flight assistance modules, each of which can be activated or deactivated by pilots at will. The first of these, named Primary Flight Control System, or PFCS, is a base set of automated functions and systems that the other two modes are built upon. As far as actual assistance, PFCS is rather limited, essentially leaving all control in the pilot's hands. This is as close to deactivated a state as the AI features can come. It opens up a plethora of options for pilots, making this mode the best for flights where situations can change rapidly and the pilots want to reserve the option to change course or elevation at a moment's notice. This mode is best suited for flying fast and low over terrain, or through a dangerous mountain pass, according to Forbes. The second module is called Automatic Flight Control System, or AFCS, and is optimized for hassle-free cargo transport. AFCS is capable of holding airspeed and altitude for a pilot, very much like cruise control or traction assists on a car. It will also lock the King Stallion into parameters for expected pitches and rolls, providing less fluidity and slower response times, but ensuring the helicopter doesn't go into any unplanned barrel rolls, which is absolutely crucial when transporting cargo, and cargo transportation is what AFCS mode is built for. Test pilots say it has a heavy, truck-like response time and is ideal for carrying heavy cargo, while a faster, jumpy response from the helicopter may spell disaster while tethered to external weight. The King Stallion's final mode is called Position Hold Hover, or PHH. Position hold hover might actually compare best to features we see in commercially available drones. It enables the King Stallion to stay in place mid-air without pilot input. If the pilot wants to adjust the position of the helicopter, he or she may do so via normal flight controls, and the PHH system will resume hovering as soon as the pilot lets go of the controls, in the exact spot the pilot leaves it. This is helpful for aligning the helicopter with cargo loads on the ground being either lifted up by ropes or tethered by external hauling. You can even lock GPS coordinates into the internal system for PHH to focus on. The chopper has been in development since 2008 when the Marines and Lockheed gave up on the CH-53K, a prototype that never cleared initial testing. The development of the design took much longer than initially thought, with the first test flights originally expected in 2011. Delays were encountered, needless to say. However, the first trial units were delivered to the Marine Corps by 2012. The Marines then went through the lengthy process of identifying design deficiencies and flaws, which the two groups have been working to stamp out ever since. Testing began in earnest in 2014, the experimental aircraft logging over 500 hours of flight time in that year alone. By 2015, we knew the new chopper would be called King Stallion. In more recent years, the final flaws have been worked out of the system, such as the issue of the engine re-ingesting gas exhaust and issues with the rotor that plagued the 2018 model. The King Stallion concluded its naval real-use scenario testing in the summer of 2020. It reportedly made 360 takeoffs and landings in a variety of conditions and times of day and night to and from the amphibious assault ship entitled WASP, meant to mimic real-world deployment scenarios. Commanders in charge of overseeing testing reported no mechanical issues, which had been a concern due to serious malfunctions in 2019, setting the program back by 2 years. The helicopter is reportedly currently undergoing hot weather trial runs similar to the naval test runs. We expect the first probationary deployment of the craft to the actual field later this year and the arrival of the 106-member fleet between 2023 and 2024. The Marines are already training pilots in specialized CH-35K VR simulators. Though developed for the USA, many countries have shown interest in the helicopter. Both Germany and Israel have orders out for a limited number of choppers, and Japan is reportedly interested in acquiring some after production, which would make sense given the King Stallion's specific naval focus. The King Stallion represents the latest in the growing trend of smart tech-powered military gear. In 2019, it was revealed that the U.S. military had built an advanced AI as part of an initiative named Sentient, meant to be a global analysis and tactical military advising program by aggregating data from thousands of satellites simultaneously. Though it may sound dystopian at first glance, it's mainly meant to do the same things as King Stallion's flight assistance system. Free up the human who previously had to worry about this to focus more on complex tasks. Though details and possible deployment plans or the possibility of second-generation prototypes are sparse right now, the military is definitely heading in the direction of integration when it comes to modern technology. Future tech isn't relegated to artificial intelligence either. AR night vision goggles and contact lenses are reportedly in the works, as are experimental exoskeletons, giving soldiers the strength of a forklift. Even more frightening is the talk of developing a fully autonomous tank-like combat vehicle to engage enemy combatants instead of US troops having to do so. There's even a robot named Skyborg that sits in fighter jet cockpits and essentially turns the aircraft into a drone piloted remotely by another soldier. The King Stallion's AI integration is nothing so far afield as these futuristic features, simply a cargo vehicle assisted by a tiny bit of autonomous tech. The King Stallion is a complex milestone in military history, as it may well represent a stepping stone to incredibly high-tech armies in the near future.